The beginning. The first Universalist Society of Lincoln was organized on September 1, 1870. Meeting at the home of Mrs. J.D. Monell were Mary Monell, Julia Brown, William Holmes, Laura Pound, Samuel Tuttle, and Reverend John and Sarah Parker. Lincoln then was a town of 2,500 people and 350 buildings. Reverend Parker was elected president of the society, with Mary Monell elected as secretary treasurer. Reverend Parker was a Universalist pastor. Mary Monell was very active in supporting and shepherding the fledgling congregation. She worked the subscription to build the chapel, collected the funds, saw that the work was done, and paid the bills. Early records reveal the zeal and fidelity with which she did the work, the many difficulties she had to contend with, and the final triumph. Mary Monell at that time was 42 years old. She had one daughter living at home, 14-year-old Kate. The Monells had moved from New York State in 1868. Her husband was co-owner and operator of the Monell and Lashley Lumber Yard in Lincoln. Weekly services were held at the state capitol. The society officially incorporated. The society received a state legislator grant of three lots on the northwest corner of 12th and H Streets to build a church. By December, the Universalist General Conference secretary had visited Lincoln and pronounced the society eligible to receive denominational support to pay a minister's salary. The first focus of the society leaders was to raise funds to build their first chapel. The Reverend Parker appears to have undertaken some such efforts even before the organizational meeting by visiting Universalist churches back east. Barely a month after the organization's meeting, a letter was received by the society that the Universalist Association Discipline Committee was charging John Parker with failing to turn over to the society all the funds he had raised on its behalf. He proceeded to preside at society meetings throughout the next year, but then left. He later was removed from the Universalist ministry. Mary Monell did fundraising closer to home with success. The following fall, Reverend James Gorton came to Lincoln, and the cornerstone for the chapel was laid October 1871. The chapel was dedicated Sunday, June 23, 1872. Unfortunately, by 1873, the financial panic of that year had caused the Universalist Convention to discontinue its support for the ministry of Mr. Gorton. He resigned after 2 years and left the area. Another early signer was Laura B. Pound. She was married to Stephen B. Pound, a local lawyer and later a judge. They had come to Lincoln from New York State. They had three children, most probably raised in our church. Oldest was Roscoe Pound, who was born in 1870. He was a legal scholar, botanist, and educator. Next was Louise Pound, who was born in 1872. She was an English professor at UNL and very active in professional organizations. Their last child, Olivia, born in 1874, was also an educator in Lincoln and wrote over 20 textbooks. Pound Middle School in Lincoln is named for her. For the next 10 years, 1873 to 1883, the society was without a settled minister. Services were random. Occasional pastors passing through Lincoln would preach, as would an Omaha Unitarian minister, Reverend Mr. Copeland. The chapel was rented to other religious organizations for meetings and such. This was a period of struggle for the chapel, including 3 years of locust infestation in Nebraska. In March of 1883, The Universalist Conventionally finally sent help in the person of Reverend Evan Chapin of Tufts University in Boston. His first 2 years were proved tumultuous. Two different factions had developed in the chapels, the ins and the outs, each with different goals for the organization. He did eventually get the congregation working together. The congregation slowly grew under Dr. Chapin's guidance. By 1893, a new church had been built at 12th and H Street. This proved to be a great financial hardship, as nationally, 1893, 1894, and 1895 proved to be very difficult years. A number of members moved away, and the Universalist General Convention withdrew its support for the society ministry. The Chapins moved to a new calling in Illinois. For the next 2 years, the church conducted a full preaching service every Sunday, young people's meetings every Sunday evening, kept up a good and efficient Sunday school, conducted the social and helpful organizations in the same regular manner. The congregation petitioned the Universalist General Convention for the ministerial subsidy to be renewed. The second year, members contacted the American Unitarian Association to see if support could be gathered from them, but were told that conversations could only be undertaken with an incorporated Unitarian society. On May 14, 1898, the Universalist General Convention telegraphed that the subsidy could not be reinstated. They realized that immediate action was necessary to relieve their financial distress. If they had taken no action, the property would have been sold at public auction to pay debts. Another society could have bought the property, and the liberal cause would have been set back many years in Lincoln. Plus, several members would have been put in severe financial distress. On Sunday the 20th, a resolution was put forth to take active steps towards securing a Unitarian church to succeed them. The resolution passed without dissent. One man, the secretary of this society, seems to be the one who shepherded the Universalist Society of Lincoln through the process of severing association with the Universalists and inviting the Unitarian Association to acquire the church and its congregation. His name was Ira Hamilton Hatfield. He was an attorney. He was married to Maud J. Roper. They had four children. He was born April of 1871 and died in February of 1914. The process was long, with much correspondence between he and the different parties. The First Universalist Society became the All Souls Church as of May 27, 1898. The new church flourished and grew steadily. 97 people signed as charter members of All Souls Church.